like Beatles in the city. Be back immediately to confiscate the money.
Race girl. Wow. My will.
You sent flowers, but you said you didn't receive. But you said
Mike
you didn't
need.
That girl is a real crowd please. Small world, all her friends know of me. Young bull living like an old geese. Quick release the cash, watch it fall slowly. Frat girl still trying to get in. Haters mad for whatever reason.
The first time I did adventure up here, I was probably 3. And I've been coming up here yearly ever since.
The first real kind of rapids I did by myself was something I named Kai's Falls. And I thought, like, Dad wouldn't let me do it, but then he said, hey, let's try that. So we went up, just scouted the line. And I did it first, so I got to name it, and I named it Kai's Falls, first descent.
Then get some more. Get you somebody that can do both. Like Beatles got the bass belly rolling. She thinks she love me, I think she trolling. That girl is a real crowd please. Small world, all her friends know of me. Young bull living like an old geese. Quick release the cash, watch it fall slowly.
We're getting some good footage that you'll see later.
Haters mad for whatever reason. Smoke in the air, binge drinking.
You know, it's crazy because he knows all the stuff up here. So if I want to do something, he knows how to do it. And he knows like what's good and what's not. So I'm always safe with him. I'm never actually scared that I'll get hurt when I'm near him. And he's very active, so he can do what I want to do also. It made me trust him so, like, with my life so much, and it made me very close bond with him, and I don't think I'll ever let go of adventuring here in the White Mountains with my dad.
I don't have any agenda for him. I don't need him to do anything for me, but when he has a goal and he achieves it, I'm happy for him, really happy for him. I'd like to live up here someday.
Me too. Have a house under Mount Washington. Mm-hmm. Just take it out of here.
A lot of traveling around the rest of the country and have been fortunate enough to see a lot of different wilderness areas and mountain ranges, and they've all been special in some capacity, but there's something about the whites that has always been home for me. I think home for me has always been more of a feeling than the space between four walls. And as vast as the White Mountains are, as different as pockets are, as different as the certain wilderness areas are, collectively, no matter where I am, what trail I'm on, I feel at home. I feel like I'm right where I need to be. I love the social aspect of the communities up here. I love hiking with my friends. It's a great place to connect one-on-one with them. But I do need that solo time, I think, because that's where I go a bit deeper with myself, and that's where my time for introspection happens. My parents generally think I'm crazy, but I remind them that it's their fault that I am this way, that they raised me to be outside a lot and to be curious and to explore. As we come out here in the mountains, we are strengthening ourselves in a myriad of ways. You know, for some people, it's just the physical strength. This is a training ground for them, and I think that's wonderful. For others, this is a place to heal, and they're made stronger, you know, through their experiences here. That I could spend a lifetime up here exploring and not see everything that I want to, not do everything that I want to. And I kind of love that there's no finishing it, there's no accomplishment, there's no end. That's very humbling.
I remember being in the back and always
to saying, why would we do this if we go up and go back down to the same exact spot? The views that you get to be able to see are amazing, and being up above treeline, it was just like a really cool feeling.
So my wife Casey and I met in college. She was the prettiest girl in the class, so I had to sit next to her. So we've always done a lot of fishing, traveling, just seeing New England. So we started driving up here and camping out, a lot of dates up here, and et cetera. And then we saw the mountains and we just decided that we'd want to climb them. So then once our kids came along, we decided to share our love for the mountains with them.
Everybody has their role, and I think it shows too on the trails. You know, everybody hikes their own hike, even though we're hiking all together. We all stop together, we wait together. You know, if anybody needs anything, you know,
someone's
always there to pick each other up. So it's pretty awesome to see. But it's a long way
like the beauty of the land and how wonderful just a simple thing is. As simple as just walking up a hill. It's so beautiful, everything you can see. But it really takes a certain person to appreciate the land and everything. And you have to protect it for the future generations to be able to enjoy it. It doesn't really have to be much to just, if you see like a rapper on the trail or anything like that, just pick up after other people and pick up after yourself. Enjoy the nature and don't ruin it for anyone else, because you enjoy it, you want other people to enjoy it too.
When you're at the top, when you could sometimes like see where the bottom was, where how far you've come up, it's just like a feeling of, wow, I did that. When I was at the bottom, I was just looking up there and saying, wow, I can never do that. But when you're at the top and looking down, you feel like you could do anything.